Hello everyone, my name is Mr. N Jersey and welcome to my channel. In this video we have got a really cool tutorial for you today. Now, probably as you saw by the thumbnail, this is going to be a PID or PID tuning tutorial. This is something that everyone has been asking for recently, and actually over the years I've seen a lot of questions on YouTube and also on Discord on how to do this. Now, this is a question that comes from new players, whether you've been playing the game for a week, or from experienced players, whether it's been 1 year, 2 years, even more here in StormX. A lot of people have trouble with configuring or tuning PIDs. Now, some players completely ignore them, don't even use them, don't bother with them, and other players do, like myself. I like to use them because they are very useful. The only problem is that when you actually want to use them, it takes a lot to configure them, whether you're doing a ballast system or maybe an altitude hold or maybe an engine controller. It all takes a lot of time to go and configure it and obviously test it here in StormX. For example, we have the 1 hour build helicopter just in front of me here, and if I wanted to add an altitude hold system to it, I would add the controller, I would maybe put some numbers in it, and I would go and test it and see how it reacts. I would then adjust that number, test it again, adjust that number, test it again. It can be a very long process. And the problem is that it's all logic. There's no visual representation. And the only visual representation we have is the actual helicopter doing its thing, going up and down, up and down, up and down. So what I've gone and done here is I've built a controller with a display that actually shows you what's happening with our PID, which will then allow you to configure and change the settings of the PID on the fly so that you don't have to go and respawn the creation, change the settings, test it out, test it out, test it out. You can all do that on the fly with the actual controller and the display that we've gone and done here. Now, I'm not going to take credit for the actual display. The display has been built by Crazy Fluffy Pony. It is a simple Lua screen with a graph bar on it, and it's got, I think, 5 graphs. I've customized it a bit, and we'll have a look at what the actual screen looks like in a few seconds. So you can see I'm starting the helicopter up. You can see there's a couple of graphs on here that actually can move up and down. And as I said, I don't take any credit for building this graph screen. This is Crazy Fluffy Pony. If you want to go check it out, go have a look on the workshop for his Lua stuff. It's really cool. But what we've gone and done, we've taken this graph screen and I've combined it with a PID tuner, which is my little logic block here, which I've gone and configured. Now, before we actually get into the details of all of this, we kind of need to understand how a PID works, okay? Not just in StormX, but in general, okay? How does it work? Well, in a nutshell, high level, what it does is you give it a set point. You say, okay, helicopter, I want to be at 25 meters. The helicopter says, okay, sure, what altitude are we at now? The system says, okay, well, I'm at, let's say, 10 meters, okay? So the system knows it needs to get 15 meters more to reach the set point. And that's where the PID comes from. It takes those two values, the set point and the variable, one being the actual altitude we want and the altitude it currently is at. And it says, okay, if you're below it, give it a positive number. And if you're above it, give it a negative number. Okay, so it will increase or decrease depending on where the variable is and what your set point is. Okay, so that in theory what it does. Now, in this controller over here, you'll see on the screen, I've got 3 different colors and 3 different labels. In red is our set point. So this will tell us where we want to be. In blue is our variable. So for example, our current altitude. Okay, so for example, you can see our current altitude here. And if we put our set point to, let's say, 45, you can see the set point jumps up there and our altitude is still down there. So it knows that it needs to get to that point to meet it together. Okay, then in green, we have the PID output. So that's either going to be a positive or negative number. So either telling the helicopter to go up or to go down. Now we can change the actual values on how this comes out. So with our PID, you have 3 different numbers, a proportional, integral, and deterative. Okay, so there's 3 different things there that you can adjust. I've got all 3 that we can adjust on the fly, okay, which is really cool. And we'll get in a little more detail on how to configure that in a few seconds. There's also a couple more things underneath here. We obviously have the altitude that we want, so that would be our set point. Our variable is the altitude coming from an altitude sensor under the helicopter. And I have 2 other keypads. I have the PID minimum and the PID max. This will allow us to tell the system how much to allow through to the throttle. Remember, if I give that throttle 1, it's going to go flying up. If I give it a negative one, it's going to go crashing down to the floor. So we can limit that, so like clamp it to how much value it's going out to it. Okay, so this is quite useful. I'm just going to go here and I'm going to clamp this to 0.3 and negative 0.3. Okay, I like to clamp that for helicopters, that way it doesn't increase too much and decrease too much, as you can adjust this as much as you want to. This controller can be used for anything, ballast system, engine controller, anything you want to see a visual representation of what's going on for your PID. Okay, so this is where it can be used. I'm using it today for an altitude hold system. We're building it completely from scratch. You can see there's currently no numbers in here. So we're going to be learning and seeing what's happening, and then we're going to be adjusting the values as we're flying, okay, which is pretty cool. Cool, now that we've got all that, we can actually jump in the helicopter. We can probably get it turned up and on. And let's get out of the hangar here. Okay, so we're going to get a little bit away from all the stuff that we can possibly crash into. You never know what's going to happen. So we're going to go here. Let's go and move it along there. And that looks about fine. Okay. So currently my altitude's 32. You can see the altitude here in the blue here. Here's the variable. So you can see our altitude. Our set point is currently 45. Okay. We can obviously go down or up and you can see how the variable is going and increasing and decreasing. Okay, so we can adjust that if we want to turn our altitude hold system on. I've got a little key switch there for it too. So now comes the time, before we turn it on, we actually need to put some settings into this. Okay, you don't have to worry about the integral and derivative at the moment. We can come back to those two values later on. Let's focus on the proportional. Okay, now you're probably thinking, well, what number do I start with? I'll start with 1, 10, 5, 2. This is up to you. What I recommend is start with 0.1 and work your way up. What we want to see is we want to see the variable going up and down above the set point. Okay, so we want it to go up and down, up and down, up and down. So oscillating between the set point. That's what we want to see. And you'll see it in a few seconds here once we go and configure this. So I'm going to go and put 0.1 in here. You can see 0.1 is going in. And I'm going to go and just decrease my altitude so you guys can actually see this thing reacting. Okay, so we are currently at around 17 meters. Okay, we want to get up to 45. I'm going to go and turn the altitude hold system on. You can now see my PID said, oops, guys, plus one, plus one, go higher, go higher, go higher. Oops, slow down, slow down, slow down, slow down, slow down. Okay, you're at the altitude. Stop sending out any value to the rotor. So you can see that value now, it's going probably as a zero. That's going out to that rotor. Okay, because we know that altitude's 45 and we set it to 45. Okay, so it's currently there. We don't see any red line. That's exactly what we want. But as I said a few seconds ago, we want this to go up and down. We want it to oscillate here. Okay, so we're going to continue increasing this until we start seeing it oscillating quite a bit. And we can adjust this. I'm going to adjust it even more. Okay, I want to see it oscillating up and down, up and down, up and down. Okay, not much. It's kind of leveled out again. So let's keep on increasing. Let's do 0.9. Let's change altitude again. You want to change your set point all the time because you want to see how it reacts. Okay, so that's why I'm adjusting it between 35 and 45. So it said go higher, go lower, go higher, go lower. See how it's oscillating now? But it's kind of leveling out, which I don't want. I want to see that big oscillation all the time. Okay, that's what I want to hit. So let's go to 1. Let's change the altitude again, maybe 35. Yeah, let's see it again. Ooh, look at that. That's almost perfect. See how it's oscillating there? The PID is going up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. That's exactly what you want to see. Okay. Once you have that, we see, look at the value. The value is 1. So we take that and we divide it by 2. So 0.5. Okay. That is the starting point for everything that we need to do. Okay, 0.5. That's the proportional gain. Once you have the proportional gain, we can now start looking at the integral. Okay. Are you thinking, what the heck does integral do? Integral will tell you how quickly or how slowly you need to get to the target, to the set point. So for example, if I set this to 65, you'll see here, it's the variable slowly going up. Yeah, you can see how slow it's slowly getting there, slowly getting there, slowly getting. Oop, yep, there we go. And now went and hit its target. But it took a while to get there. Okay, it took a little bit of time to get there. So you can adjust this to either go quicker or slower. I wanted to go quicker, so I'm going to go 0.0. Let's do 0.04. Why not? Okay. So that should now get to its target much quicker. You can see now it's actually going way above where we need to do it. You can see it's kind of overshooting, going too much, going too little. So let's go and decrease this down. So let's start with 0.001. Yeah, so I've got three zeros there after the decimal. Go and insert that, and let's go and put it to 45. And let's see what's happening. So you can see now the variable is going down. The PID is still negative one, and then it's going up, and it's going and slowing down. Okay, so you can adjust this as much as you want to. Okay, it's completely up to you on how quickly you want it to react to different changes. Okay, so 55. Oops, you can see how it went there, and it now went and balanced out. Okay, you can see it's going to slowly go and get back to that. So we can adjust this as much as we want to. It's completely ups. Ideally, as I said earlier, we want to get the variable and the set point together. Okay, if you increase this too much, you'll see it's going to jump way too quickly over back to the set point, and it's going to overshoot it by a lot. Okay, you want to get that to where it just overshoots it. Okay, just overshoots it. So let's do 0.02. Let's go and change the value now to like 35. Another thing that you also want to just take in mind is that for a helicopter, it's not always just going to be going up and down a level. You're also going to be going forwards. Okay, so you can see how we're going forwards now. Okay, you can see our variable is coming and meeting up. Our PID is saying, hey, increase. But currently, you can see how that variable drops down there, and then it starts dropping up. So when I let go of the S, it started dropping up. But you can see how the variable was going down, but our PID was all the way up to positive one. That's because our actual controller doesn't have enough power to give over to the engine. Okay, our engine's not powerful enough. Now there's two ways of getting around this. One, get a more powerful engine, or two, increase the maximum that you have here. So for example, if I put this up to one now, saying, hey, you can go fully, you can tell that rotor blade, it can go fully, you go all the way up. Have a look now what happens. Gonna go forwards again. See how this goes up now? And look how our variable is staying at the same point as the set point. Yeah, variable is still going up. It's saying, hey, I need more power to maintain that set point. As soon as I let go of W, look what happens. It says, oh, I don't need any more power. You can have it back. And it still maintains our set point. Okay, so you want to make sure that you have enough power going to the engine. Okay, or you increase the maximum. The only problem with increasing the maximum is look what happens when I change the altitude now. Look how it shoots up. It suddenly gets a burst of one and then drops all the way down. Okay, and you can see now it's going and it's overshooting its target a bit. So it's now going and pushing it up, and it's now going and leveling out. But that's the overshoot over there. It's going too much and then it's dropping down. So how do we fix the overshoot? That's where we have the D value of the PID. Okay, this will allow us to dampen when it gets to the final point. Same rule applies here. Start with a low value and work your way up. Let's start with 0.5. Okay, and let's see what happens there. So we're going to change our altitude again. So let's do 35 this time. So you can see the PID went all the way down. Once it starts leveling out, we'll see the green come back. Okay, still waiting. Yep, can you see how it went up and then went down again? Okay, so there's still a bunch of dampening that we could in theory do, or we could even remove some. Okay, let's increase the dampening, let's do 2. Okay, and watch how different this is gonna be now when we change this. So let's go to 45. So it went and shot up. It's now saying go down a bit. Okay, so it's still overshooting its value a bit. So we can increase, let's say 4. Change its value again, so let's do 55. Go up, please. And you can see now we're getting a little bit less of that overshoot. Okay, and we can continue adjusting this and adjusting it. I actually think we're going a little bit too quickly. So I'm going to put our integral down to 0.000, so 3 zeros and 1 5. Okay, so I'm slowing it down a bit. Let's go and change the altitude now. Let's do like 75. So set points over there. Dunk. Great. We went a little bit over the target. And once again, that's probably because our PID is maxed out. I'd probably bring this down to about 0.3. Okay, and have a look now what happens. 55, let's do 85. See, there we go, look at that. See how it didn't overshoot? It didn't go all the way down and then drop itself up again? That's because we have the dampening. But because we've limited the max, the amount that the rotor can get when we actually move forwards, you'll notice that the PID is going to say, I need more power, I need more power. But unfortunately, the engine can't give it enough, okay, because it's clamped to 0.3. So we need to unclamp that to get more power. As I said, the easiest way to fix that is get more power in your rotor blades, so bigger engines. This is just a small baby engine in this, so it can't keep up with it. But that's pretty much about it. Guys, you let me know what you think about this. I'm hoping that this display is going to be quite nice and useful. It's an easy way to visualize the settings of a PID here in Stormworks, and you can see what's happening. You can see if it's going too high, too low. You can see if it's taking too long to react. You can see if it's going too quickly, and you can adjust the settings on the fly. Just remember to always adjust your set point so that you can actually see the change happening. If I just change it now, nothing is really going to happen here. Okay, so just be aware of that. As I said earlier, I don't take any credit for the graph. The graph is not mine, but the controller is. I built the controller that actually has the PID inside it with all these settings on it. So if you want to see this on the workshop and you maybe want to use in your own creation, drop a like in this video and let me know in the comments, and then I possibly might put it over on the workshop. But as always, I hope you have enjoyed this video and found it some entertaining and informative as always, and we'll see you in the next one.